Hello everybody, we are back again, Bum Chef is back and I'm gonna show you once more how to cook like a bum. The most important thing that you have to know when you are a bum, you don't have any money. You probably know because you don't have any. This is why our meals are rather small. Today we are just cooking this cauliflower. It was the smallest they had in the supermarket, and it would be a lot bigger if we just take a tiny bowl, pan, and I'm just kidding. We take this thing, a whole cauliflower. As you can see, I've left the leaves on it. I often see people ripping off the leaves in the supermarket. And this is one of many times when I think those idiots, because those leaves contain water. If you rip them apart in the shop and then put it in your refrigerator for 2 or 3 more days, it will start withering. And you can avoid that simply by leave those leaves where they are. And if you start cooking, you start removing them. This is what we do now. You can imagine ripping off the jaw of a person that you don't like, who was mean to you. Ah, take this, grandma. Ah. And the inner part needs to be removed. You can try it like this, but you will probably end in a hospital. Half it and then 2 cuts like this and you're good. And then we start ripping them even more apart. The whole cauliflower needs to be tiny bits. Not too tiny, but small. You can try it with a knife, but in the end, it's best to do it with your bare hands. No green stuff and also no things like the very hard inner parts. They just tend to get bitter if you cook them, and as I said before, they are hard. Not enjoyable to eat. This now may take a while. Okay, 2 things now. This still takes a while, but I'm bored already, so I'm gonna talk a bit more. First, what's the name of this whole thing? It will be cauliflower risotto. A risotto is most of the time made with mushrooms. If you are a really posh person, meaning the exact opposite of a bum, you can use a yellow boletus. Oh, if you can afford them, that is. Well, I can't, so I take a cauliflower. And before I forget, I almost forget, we need hot water, boiling hot water. Now I may continue. And while performing this, you can still, it really helps. Imagining that you are ripping apart, like ripping out the teeth of your boss. Take this, Mr. Smith. Here are your teeth. Or you don't. You just simply do it without being aggressive. This was the first part of ripping apart things. Now we need the hot water for a tea. Who would have thought? I don't know what I fill in these little bags. But that's not all we need the water for. We need some chicken consomme. If you, by any circumstances, have a real consomme from a cooked chicken, the water in which you cooked a chicken, use this. Don't throw the water away. It's a perfect consomme, not only for this dish, but for many dishes. If you don't, you can use some instant consomme, but it's instant. What should I say? Instant is never as good as fresh. Then we take a slice of butter. Everybody loves butter. And heat it. With pines. A whole bag, most of the time it's 50 grams, 60 grams, like this. And this is about around a kilo, a bit less than a kilo. And two garlic sprouts. Cooking spoon, garlic in the press, and the cooking spoon is wood, just as my board. I don't like plastic at all. Everything has to be steel or iron or wood in the kitchen. Pressing the garlic. It was a bit much maybe for this little press, but go multiple times, no problem. And while this is being heated up, mix it a bit. We will use our fingers once more. This time it's some blue molded cheese. You can also take goat cheese with ashes around it. It's just, yes, something like this exists. Goat cheese with coated with ash. But it's a matter of taste. I like blue cheese more, blue molded cheese. And people ask, is this just a name, right? Mold? That's not really mold around it. Unlike chicken nuggets that don't contain real chicken, mold is really mold in this case, and it's tasty mold. You don't get sick, maybe you puke a bit, but that's not because it makes you sick, it's because you are maybe disgusted, but you shouldn't. It's tasty, you just have to try it without hating on it beforehand too much. Just give it a try, at least in this dish. You don't have to eat it pure, just cook with it. That's all. Also something you can just rip apart or cut it, however you prefer. I've ripped apart this thing and this is why I'm cutting now, but it's a pain with this knife. Cooling it really down helps, makes it able to be cut better. Really a pain. But as you can see, it doesn't need to be fine little cubes, just smaller, just like this. The pines are getting a good, nice color, nice brown. And we reduce the heat to a very low state and add the sprouts of the cauliflower. Mm. And now we add the consommé. We can prepare another slice of butter, like this. And now we heat it up some more. I would say half of the most possible heat you can do with your oven. And while we wait, we clean up this mess we made before a bit. Take a look. Meanwhile, the cauliflower has become a nice brown coat. I love nice brown coats, if you haven't noticed by now. But it's still really hard. About 10 minutes have passed. It's still too hard. We will let it cook more until it's getting softer. You will feel it just by adding the poking around with the cooking spoon a bit in it. Still too hard. I would give it another 10 minutes, heat it up some more, one more step, and wait again. Don't add a top of it because the consommé needs to fly away. It has to leave the pan. Some more time has passed. Not as much as I thought, just another 5 minutes. And it's getting softer, but don't let it get too soft. It's not, it doesn't need to be so soft that you can serve it. Because there now comes the cheese. It's around like just, let's say, 70% as ready as and as soft as you wish to eat it, let's say, in the end. Butter and the blue molded cheese with real mold. Of course it's real mold. And we mix all together. The butter and the cheese will melt and both will suck up all the remaining fluid from the consommé. Important thing is that you spread the cheese and the butter all over, keep it in moving, when I think about it, it's not that much different than mac and cheese. Just that the mac is, the macaroni is cauliflower and the cheese is real cheese. Not this synthetic instant cheese chemistry Happy Meal cheese. When it's spread all over the pan, we let it cook until all the unnecessary liquid is gone, has been cooked away, so to say, and the whole meal is getting all hardly fluid, just like mac and cheese. You know mac and cheese, it has to be of the same consistent. And 15 more minutes have passed. That's more time than I thought, but it really took that long to get all the liquid out of it. Maybe we have used a bit too much consommé, I don't know. But In the end, I wouldn't say so. Because the longer it cooks, the more everything flows together. All the tastes. So, that's it. As you can see, almost anything of the liquid has gone away, flown away. And this is the time to serve it. And there you go. Another Bum Chef original cauliflower risotto. Remember, if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.